Thin film deposition is widely used in the semiconductor industry. Here at APL, we have two deposition processes for depositing tellurium-based semiconductors for thin film thermoelectric applications, phase change materials, and topological insulators.
We do thin film deposition via MBE in this lab. Come on in.
In the molecular beam epitaxy lab, the MBE lab for short, we grow various materials under ultra-high vacuum conditions for very precise control of layer-by-layer growth on the order of atom-by-atom angstroms at a time. We do this by monitoring the reed image, where we are looking at the surface diffraction in situ during growth and throughout the process. When complete, we get a thin film material that can be used in a wide variety of semiconductor applications.
For the other deposition process, we need to take a ride. Welcome to the MOCVD lab. This is where we do thin film deposition.
From the MBE lab, where we're growing very thin atomic layers, we move into the MOCVD lab, where we're growing many microns of material at a time. For the epitaxy process, a surface treatment prior to growth is required. We start off with a chemical process where we clean the surface. When we start initialize growth on these surfaces, anything that breaks off not clean will disrupt the crystals that we're growing. So we take care in prepping our acids and solvents that we use throughout the cleaning process. After cleaning the wafer, we blow dry in ultra-high purity nitrogen and then move into the reactor as fast as possible to avoid any potential surface contamination. We want to keep that surface pristine prior to loading into the reactor chamber where thin film deposition will be initiated. At the end of this, again, we end up with a thin film semiconductor up to roughly 20 microns that is used in thermoelectric applications.
And that's our deposition process for thin film thermoelectric.